Hey guys, so I have just a quick bit of info for you before we start this video. My friend Taxonomist is going to be showing us how she creates the homemade diet that I use for Kashi, and this is something that I use alongside with two commercial brands, and I am incredibly thankful for the time that Tax spends doing this because it is a lot of work and time and money. So I did want to specifically mention that she does not have this mix available for people to buy, and I will be listing her reasons why in my pinned comment below. This is a question I've had people ask me in past, so I thought that it was worth covering. And I also wanted to mention that I will have a bunch of links listed in the description that will provide you with more information on creating a homemade hamster mix if this is something that interests you. So please be sure to check all of those links out. It's extremely important that you research how to properly do this because it's not just a matter of tossing together random ingredients that sound healthy. You do have to have the proper guaranteed analysis and percentages of everything. So now that I have these disclaimers out of the way, I'm going to get into the video now. I hope you guys find this helpful, and also a huge thanks to Taxonomist for spending the time with me to film this video.
Everyone, it's Tax. So today I'm going to be making HoppingHammy some of my homemade hamster mix, and she's going to be here helping me and filming it for me. The first thing I have here is just all of my equipment that I'll be using. This is my scale. It's got a capacity of 100 grams, and it weighs to the nearest 1/100 of a gram, so 0.01. It's a very, very, very precise scale to make sure I have the exact correct measurements. I have a plastic spoon and a couple plastic cups. This is just for scooping and putting seeds in. And then I have my little kit here. This will just be in the beginning. I need to calibrate the scale to make sure it's weighing accurately, especially with small amounts. So I'm actually just gonna do that now. And we'll start with a 20 gram weight. And it's gonna fall over because that's just how it goes. And it is weighing in at 1999, which is actually about as close as it's gonna get. This isn't a super high grade scientific precision scale. It was $10 on Amazon, so. So first I'm going to start out with my grains and other seeds that are high in carbs. These are a big portion of the diet. They're basically just carbs and fiber. Basically the bulk of the energy that the hamster would have. This category includes things like oats, rice, barley, rye, wheat, sorghum, millet, all sorts of different grains, and a few that aren't technically grains but are pretty much the same nutritionally. So basically I just dump everything in. And I usually do too much and have to pull it back and dump it back in my bag. Perfect. And there, that's the complete mix. It really isn't, that's just the first step. We're going to be doing that about 35 more times, more or less, which I'm sure you're not going to see the real time of every single one because that would be a little tedious, I would think. This one is hulled barley. This one is wheat. It always looks very, very boring when I'm just doing the seeds. So this is actually it for the seed portion. And next we're going to be starting on some new ingredients that'll add a little more color and variety of size and texture. So my next category is legumes. Basically think beans and peas. These are high in protein, high in fiber, and typically pretty low in fat. There are some exceptions, the soybeans that we're currently looking at being one of them. Wow, remember how I said we're gonna add more color? Not exactly true for the soybeans. I was just about to say that we're now going to get into some color and then realized I chose beige butternut squash as my first example. But my next category is vegetables. This is something that I feel like a lot of people who make homemade mixes don't include. It's definitely a more rare type of thing, but I think vegetables in a dry mix are incredibly beneficial. They provide a lot of different micronutrients. They provide prebiotic fiber. I get my vegetables from a company called North Bay Trading. I order them online. They're pretty decently priced. It does add up with the number of vegetables I use because I've got, I think like 10 to 15 different types of vegetables. But they come in big bags, so they last me like a couple years. Squashes like zucchini and butternut squash are some of the most nutrient-dense vegetables out there. They have a little bit of natural sugar, so that makes them appealing as well, but they are just absolutely packed with vitamins and minerals. Corn that you find in hamster mixes really doesn't have a whole lot going for it in terms of nutrition. It's kind of just carbs. But this is sweet corn. This is the same as what you or I would eat, you know, corn on the cob or frozen corn. It's not like rock solid like the corn you find in hamster food. And it is different nutritionally. It has a lot of vitamins and minerals in it. So just a tip for anyone who is considering adding some dried vegetables to their hamster's diet. I found that for leafy greens, it's better to buy freeze-dried versus air-dried. I used to buy air-dried spinach, and what kind of happens with it, I mean, not what happens, it comes like this, is it's a lot of powder and very fine flakes. It gets everywhere, and it just sort of sits there and floats around, and it just, I don't know how much of it gets eaten because it just sort of ends up all over the place. So I've actually switched over to freeze-dried, which is really interesting. I just opened this bag and saw what it was like, but it's like really big chunks of spinach. But these weigh nothing. Like, it's kind of hard to convey that over video, but they have zero weight to them. It's like holding styrofoam. But I'm hoping these will be a little neater and they provide, you know, a nice little like chunky bite for the hamster to eat. I will definitely be sticking with freeze-dried going forward for these particular types just because it's a lot less messy. So this looks like a ton, but it's because it's so light, and this is why it's important to use weights and not volumes to measure. Because this looks about the same amount as the carrots, I'd say, right? But it's a third of the weight of the carrots. There's a lot less by weight, but because it's just so light and bulky, it looks like more. That's why weighing dry ingredients is always more accurate than measuring them with cups or tablespoons or anything like that. You always want to go by the weight in grams or ounces or however you choose to do it. So this is our kale. And these weigh like even less than nothing. They're also freeze dried, but like you can't even feel that. Like that doesn't feel like anything to me when I'm doing that. This is the finished mix.